For this project, we begin with a new inventor file in English unit, standard IPT, and create. Our sketch plane for this one is going to be XZ plane because we are beginning on top view, on plan view. We draw a rectangle. 2 points center option. Add dimension to be 2.5. Other side is the same. This is a square. So we add equal relations. The sketch is fully constrained, finish sketch. The next sketch will be another sketch on top of this, another rectangle on top of this one. For that, we need to create a new plane. We go to plane, select offset from plane option, expand your origin to see the plane that you started from was XZ plane. Highlight that. Add distance that you want this new plane to be from this XZ plane. That distance is given 2. Now we have created a new plane, which automatically Inventor names Work Plane 1. Right click on Work Plane 1, New Sketch. Create another rectangle with the same 2-point center option. The center will be the same origin, snap to origin. Click a point on the screen. Add dimension. This one is going to be 1 by 1 square. Add equal relation between two sides. Fully constrained, finish sketch. By default, this new plane is visible. If you want to turn them off, right click on that plane, check mark the visibility, make sure it's off. Now we have two squares. They are 2 inches apart on top of each other. We will use loft feature. Select the loft feature from ribbon on the feature ribbon menu. And then select, we don't have to change any of these settings except the default. Simply select both rectangles. This can be selected in any order. And you have completed this shape. Now we go back to remove this part of this bottom portion by creating another sketch on XY plane. XY plane falls exactly in the middle because we started with the origin as a center. Right click and select a new sketch on XY plane. In order to see that what you are working on that plane, make that plane, your visibility on view or visual style on the view to be wireframe. Go to the view, visual style, select wireframe. Let's create that second sketch. This time we will be using sketch line and create this little trapezoid shape. Selecting some approximate shape like that. and then add necessary dimension. This one is, I believe, is given 1. This bottom base is 1.5. Height is given also on this one. If just to follow on the handout sheet, you will see all this information. This is also 1 unit. Is the best option here would be to drawing a line from the origin, just some center line here. Make this one center line. And then add relations between sides of this trapezoid to be symmetrical in reference to the center line by selecting the constraint symmetric. For this, first select the sides and then select the center line. They are symmetrical to this. Now we have this line, the base, has to move perfectly here. The reason I did this outside is much easier to pick the points. When you start on the line exactly, it's very hard to pick those. Select collinear option and select the line and select the edge of this to fall exactly there. And it's asking 1 dimension needed. That most likely is the for center line. You can either add dimension to the center line or just drag this one to midpoint of this line. That should eliminate that need for that center line. So that is completed. Finish the sketch. You notice that's exactly in the middle. We go to extrude and select new profile, extrude both directions with through all option. Accept. Try repeat one more time. Extrude. Select both options, both directions, and through all. Cut. Perhaps I did not select the cut. The message you saw, because it was on the join option, it caused the problem. And here, I needed to use the cut through all. That completes our model. You want to change back your view to visual style with shaded mode with edge and add material such as what we have here is wood, maple. That completes your assignment by adding the annotation to the model. General note, make it volume for this one. Volume equal to volume syntax and apply, and that update to show your information on the model. Update and close. And save your file and submit your file through Canvas.